Welcome back. The Prime Minister was in the Gandhi pocket borough of Amethi today. He spoke about the inauguration of a major project in Amethi, a factory where AK-203 rifles for the Indian Army will be made. He also hit out at the Gandhis for being unable to do anything substantive as far as that factory is concerned and development in the region. What sort of impact will this make in the elections?
आपके यहाँ के सांसद जब 2007 में इसका शिलान्यास किया तब ये कहा गया था कि साल 2010 से इसमें काम शुरू हो जाएगा. हुआ क्या? उन्होंने कहा था कि नहीं किया, कहा था. उनकी सरकार ठीक नहीं थी, वो जो कहे वो होना चाहिए तक नहीं होना चाहिए था. हुआ क्या? अरे जो इतना ही नहीं कर पाते उनका भरोसा काहे को करते हो. और ये भी मत भूलिए, उन्होंने कहा था कि 1500 नौजवानों को रोजगार देने का वायदा किया था. किया था भाई, 1500 लोगों को फैक्ट्री में वादा किया था. इस अमेठी की बात है, देश की नहीं कर रहा हूं, लेकिन इतनी बड़ी बातें करने वाले लोगों ने अमेठी के लोगों की आंख में धूल झोंकी और सिर्फ 200 लोगों को काम मिला. ये लोग कौन थे? कौन लोग थे? मैं किसी का नाम नहीं लूंगा, लेकिन आप भलीभांति जानते हैं कि ये कौन लोग थे. आप भलीभांति जानते हैं कि कौन लोग थे. और आप जानते हैं, मुझे किसी का नाम कहने की जरूरत नहीं है, भाई और बहनों, हमारे देश को आधुनिक राइफल ही नहीं, आधुनिक बुलेट प्रूफ जैकेट ही नहीं, आधुनिक तोप के लिए भी इन्हीं लोगों ने इंतजार कराया.
Well, joining us now to discuss this, the attack of the Prime Minister in Amethi, the Gandhi pocket borough, Mohammed Khan of the Congress, Ghanshyam Tiwari, the Samajwadi Party, Desh Ratan Nigam, the political analyst and lawyer with us, also Javed Ansari, the senior journalist. Let me come to you, in fact, Mr. Ansari, first. Is it your belief that, you know, I mean, from that national security now, post the Pulwama terror attack, post the Balakot attacks, post the entire Wing Commander Abhinandan issue, is going to change, is going to be the definitive sort of aspect of the elections in terms of what political parties do. Today in Amethi, the Prime Minister was talking about a rifle factory over there, again feeding into that central theme of national security. Is this the way things are headed?
Vishnu, I have no doubt in my mind that this will play a significant role. Now, whether this alone is the issue that determines voting patterns, I'm not so sure. But certainly this is something that cannot be wished away. The BJP will try and milk it for whatever it's worth. When I say this, I'm also, any other political party, were it the Congress or the Samajwadi, were there in power at the center, they would have done the same. So the BJP will try and milk it for whatever it's worth. And the opposition needs to now come up with a strategy on how to counter this. Do you counter this by merely questioning, by asking questions, or maybe, as some have suggested, the opposition could also join the chorus saying that we all supported this issue, so therefore the credit cannot just go to one party, the credit must go to our armed forces. But certainly this is an issue that will not go away in one form or the other. This will form a part of the narrative going forward.
Mohammed, how would you respond to what the Prime Minister had to say in Amethi, that for 10 years a factory which was supposed to be a weapons factory in Amethi hasn't been developed? It's for this government, this party, to actually develop it.
Well, I would say the following to Mr. Modi. I would say, if the voters of Amethi did not believe you in 2014 when you were at your peak popularity, I doubt they will do so now. Mr. Modi is clearly unaware of the development work done in Amethi. I could list out all the 9 industrial plants, unparalleled by any other district of UP that exists in Amethi, from HAL to BHEL. I could also talk about the ordnance factory at Korba, which exists. I could talk about the fact that the Amethi railway station is probably the only one that is connected to every state in the country. Even before it became a tehsil, this railway station was upgraded and is a pride for the people of Amethi. I could talk about all of those things, but I'm certain they'll be wasted on Mr. Modi. I want to answer the question you asked Javed Sahab. I think Modi ji se jo gussa hai, wo bahut bunyadi hai. And that is something that he fails to understand. And he still fails to understand it, and it is evident he fails to understand it, because his speeches still fall into the same threefold pattern. Talk about the Gandhi family, try and make some jokes at their expense, talk about his narrative of victimhood, and talk about the fact that, you know, now that there is the army, now that there is the surgical strikes issue, try and co-opt that for personal gain. People see through that. People see through that. And that does very little to remove the source of the anger against Mr. Modi. Mr. Modi is leaving behind two very problematic legacies. One of financial hardship across the board, from farmers to middle-class individuals to students, and of hate and divisiveness. These are things that no amount of jumlebazi will wash away, Vishnu.
Okay. Mr. Deshratha Nigam, how would you respond to that? He's listed the areas in Amethi where the Congress, he says, has developed the particular area. The Prime Minister, he says, has not said anything new. How would you respond?
See, the fact remains that if you just take a simple visit to Amethi, you will see the gross underdevelopment which is there. And that is what has been highlighted by the Prime Minister. The delayed projects is one aspect which is an all-India phenomenon. Hundreds of projects which were left just like that have been completed by this government. He's just given you one example of the rifles factory, which was the foundation stone was laid in 2007. So he's also telling the Gandhis that you've lost the turf there. And as I've said also in your channel that Mr. Gandhi may or may not contest from Amethi, or he may contest from two or three places. That's the prediction I have made before. And I stick by it.
And I completely reject Deshratan Sahab.
Is that the case?
No, absolutely not. See, again, this is what the BJP does. They try and script a false narrative because they're so used to propaganda. Sir, it's not 2014.
He suggested it. I don't think
he was. The fact is that ultimately, the people of Amethi decided in 2014 and they're certainly going to decide in 2019 and explain this to Mr. Modi in very, very clear terms. Why don't you tell me something, Deshratan Sahab? Mr. Modi's first visit to Amethi, if I'm not mistaken, correct? Why did it take him 5 years to go there? If his love for the people is so profound and his commitment to the people of this region is so great, then 5 years lag gaye on the eve of elections, 22 days before elections are taking place, he's here announcing a project that will not be fulfilled until the next term. Clearly, jumle bazo mein to aap log raja hai.
All right, Ghanshyam Tiwari, before the two of you start fighting, how big was the presence of the Prime Minister today in Amethi? This has been an area which has been almost unassailable as far as the presence of the Gandhis is concerned. Do you believe that given the change in narrative to national security and the fight against terror, things might be changing in favor of the BJP, which is seen to be in a particularly bad position now in UP with the alliance with the BSP?
Well, push to edge, the BJP is responding with naked propaganda. And that naked propaganda can be fully represented right here in Delhi by the Delhi Member of Parliament, Mr. Manoj Tiwari, who also happens to be party adhyaksh. On the day Pulwama happened, he was dancing all night.
Yeah.
And on the day the government did airstrikes, he said at 3:40 he had tears in his eyes because God told him that some airstrike has happened. And today pictures are flashing of him wearing army fatigue and doing Vijay Sankalp rally. In these 14 days when Mr. Manoj Tiwari has been doing fancy dress and dance and tune, India has lost 60 brave sons. 56 inch ki chhati hai ya hamare 56 shahidon ki shahadat hai? That is the question the nation is asking. We have stood behind this government, but we will not stand behind the theatrics of a government where the Prime Minister is busy shooting feature film for a private channel. The Prime Minister clearly politicizes something and then weakens India's position, saying that if we had Rafael, we would have a different story. What does he mean? When the world is asking us our story, you stand up and you say that we have one story and here it is, rather than start saying that if we had a Rafael, we would have a different
story. Deshratan Nigam, would you accept what he says over there, that the imaging, the statements from the government, I mean, what are they substantiated by? For example, the claim of 300 people killed in Balakot. Everybody knows India attacked. But where is that number emerged from? And what is there to actually back it at this particular juncture?
See,
why till now have our journalists looking for scoops to see what has been hit, what has not been hit? Why doesn't the government just come out and say we hit something or we didn't hit something? How does it take away from anything?
See, I'm sure the government is collecting all those evidence. The territory lies in Pakistan and therefore probably the defense forces are also must be giving the feedback. And I'm sure in due course of time you will have everything. We do not know how many people have been killed. I do not know the sources of 300, 350. But certainly the news that is emanating from Pakistan says the strike has also taken place and number of people, casualties have taken place. But all those have to be verified by the government of India and the data put in public domain. And I'm sure defense forces will come out with being in Pakistan territory. I'm sure it requires some hard intelligence to give it. And when they want to give it, it is their choosing.
Yeah, but see, that in fact is what I wanted to ask Mr. Ansari next. The sense that whatever further evidence that has to be shown, if it needs to be shown, is not being shown now because it can be shown later on to score political points. Is that the real concern now? That these images of the Balakot strikes, further evidence on what we may have done to Pakistan, is going to be showcased at a time when it suits the government in power for a political objective. National security is not a political game per se.
You're absolutely right. National security is not a political game, and political parties across the board should resist the temptation of again politicizing it or milking it. But we this is not a perfect world that we live in, and I'm not so sure if any of the others, not just the BJP, but if any of the others were they in such a position, would have refrained from doing so. It'll be sad. It's a pity that issues of national security will also be used in this election, but that's the way the things are.
Vishnu, may I?
Mr. Deshrath Nigam first, then Muhammad. Yeah.
See, let me tell you, when you ask such a question, there lies a presumption that that everything the government has prepared a dossier and is not releasing it to the people. I mean, that presumption should not be made. Probably they are collecting the evidence. I think that we should not venture into that domain right now.
Okay, can I come in now?
Yeah, Muhammad, yeah. Go ahead.
So there is this word you people like using and patting yourself on the back with, Chanakya Niti, Chanakya Panti. You use it at the drop of a hat, very fast.
There is
and
nothing
loose,
called Chanakya Panti, please.
Absolutely, Chanakya
please,
Niti.
Please.
Chanakya Niti, yes, of course.
Please.
I'm using it the way your trolls use it.
Don't anyway, insult the greatest person that displays this country.
No,
absolutely.
I agree with you. Let us get to the point now. Now, I think true diplomacy, which is what Chanakya Niti is, if you had studied the Kautilya's Arthashastra, is outward facing. And I think there our Prime Minister was enormously lacking. In the 2 days when we were facing this grave crisis and our armed forces and Wing Commander Abhinandan displayed the kind of resilience that is the stuff of legends, our Prime Minister was talking about Khelo India, Khelo and Mera Booth Sabse Mazboot. Now, I want to ask you this. After that as well, he comes out, starts talking about if we had the Rafale jet, we would have done better. Our Prime Minister is supposed to represent us, as Ghanshyam Bhai said, to the world in a crisis like this. Here I will point out to you the example of the OIC. You and your colleagues, Mr. Nigam, went to every channel and celebrated prematurely the invite to the OIC, saying you've scored a diplomatic victory. Did you celebrate yesterday when the OIC issued one of the most vulgar statements against India possible? It was
okay.
A complete undoing of 10 years of diplomatic
work. Mr. Nigam,
work.
Last word to you. I need to wrap this up.
What
Go
is
ahead.
Your excuse for that? Where
Mr.
Is your
Nigam, last word to you.
That?
Yes.
Is it to me?
Yes.
See, let me tell you this, I am not going to fall in the trap of rhetoric. Government of India is well within its rights to, you know, to make announcements when they feel it is correct. It is their prerogative. And Prime Minister has clearly sent a message that the business in India will not stop. The working of the government will not stop. And at the same time, the government of India will strike the terrorist camps as and when they desire.
Okay. Okay, Mr. Tiwari, you had something to say.
Well, I believe that jingoism runs on illiteracy. And the more BJP does jingoism on national security, the illiteracy of its cadres, even to the...
why don't you be honest, Mr. Tiwari? Aren't you really worried that the discourse in these elections has changed?
No, I am not.
Yeah,
because
the discourse of development may have gone. The discourse against agrarian distress may just have been replaced a little bit by something completely different. Because if there is any one unifier in this country, it's the sense of pride in the national forces, and it's on hitting out at Pakistan and hitting out at terrorists.
Well, two pictures.
So how has that not changed?
Two pictures stand out. One, it has changed for BJP. BJP has now started talking only about
that
its
doesn't
naked
worry
propaganda.
You? That doesn't worry you?
And that is getting, the second part of it is what I was saying was jingoism runs on illiteracy. The actions of Sakshi Maharaj, the action of Manoj Tiwari, it is exposing the Farji Rashtrawad that BJP is trying to build its campaign on. The campaign on the ground is still on jobs, still on farmer issues, still on social harmony, and still on the real issue. We want to respond to terrorism.
All right.
We want to respond to Pakistan. But we want to respond from a position of strength rather than position of electoral theatre.
Well, we'll see who's 22 days. We'll see who's in a position of strength and what the real issues are. I'd like to thank all of you very much for joining us. An important day today in Amethi with the Prime Minister over there hitting out at the Gandhis and development over there. But the Congress hitting right back saying that, look, this is all of what we have done. And then let's not politicize the issue of national security. Moving on, a professor of an engineering college in Karnataka's Vijaypura was forced to go down on his knees and apologize with folded hands for putting up a post on Facebook. We'll bring you more details of that in just a few minutes.